गुड मॉर्निंग, वेलकम बैक इंग्लिश बाल भारती क्लास 4। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अ नेक्स्ट चैप्टर फ्रॉम आवर इंग्लिश बाल भारती टेक्स्ट बुक, चैप्टर नंबर 34, द किंग ऑफ द गोल्डन रिवर। सी, इन दिस लेसन इज डिवाइडेड इंटू टू पार्ट्स। टुडे we will learn about the first part of this story. Let's read the story. Chapter number 34, The King of the Golden River. See, long, long ago, in the mountainous part of a country, there was a fertile valley. There were many waterfalls leaping down the mountain's top, but not into the valley. They all ran down the other side of the mountain. One of the falls was very high and shone like gold in the beams of the evening sun. People called it the Golden River. See, in this paragraph we understood that there was a country. It was a mountainous place. It has a fertile valley. Now, fertile means what? Able to produce the crops and the grains. Valley means a low area between the hills, which leaping down in the mountain top, but not onto the valley. Leaping means flowing towards, flowing that downwards. On of all the falls was shining. It was a very shiny, that beams means rays of the evening sun, and the people called it the Golden River. It means it was a very shiny. The sun shined brightly in that valley. It looks like a brown color. So the people called the river as a Golden River. See the next passage. Now, though there were no streams running down to the valley itself, the wind constantly brought the clouds to the valley. Even when the rest of the country was dry, it always run in the valley. In the valley, the wind and the clouds made the crops green, the hay high, and the apples red, the grapes purple, and honey sweet. People called it the Treasure Valley. Now there was a stream running down on the valley itself. Wind constantly blowing on the valley, and country was dry. If the country was dry, in that time the valley ran, and because of the rain, crops growing over all over there, greenery only, and the apples are red in color, grapes purples, and the honey sweet. So there was lot of food crops. Because of that, people called it as a Treasure Valley. The Treasure Valley belonged to the three brothers, Kavach, Hans, and Gluck. The two older brothers were big, ugly, and weak. They were good farmers, but they killed everything that was not profitable for them. Even little things that blackbirds, hedgehogs, and cricket. They did not treat their servants well and gave them only poor wages. They waited till the corn had become very expensive in the market, then sold it for twice its value. They were very rich, but never ever gave even so much as a penny to the poor. People called them the Black Brothers. See, there was three brothers who live in that Treasure Valley. Their name was Scabbard, Hans and Glug into the brothers were a good farmers, but they killed that whatever was not profitable for them, like the blackbirds, hedgehogs and crickets. They treat their servants in a bad way. Wage means what? The money that is paid for work that is the person does. They gave a very little money to their servant who worked for them. Even with their servants, they are treated badly who work for them. They still waited for that corn became expensive in the market, so they sold it onto in a double rate. That's why they were very rich, but they did not give any single coin to anyone. That the people called them the Black Brothers. That is the reason they are not given any single coin to the other people, and they are treated with everyone in a bad manner. So the people call them the Black Brothers. See the next passage. Next one. The youngest of three brothers was only 12 years old. He was just the opposite of his brothers. He was kind to every living thing, though his own brothers were cruel to him and made him do all the cooking and mending all the housework for them. See, the youngest brother of these three brother, whose name was the Glug, he was only 12 years old, and he was different from two brothers because they are very cruel, unkind. He was very kind. The Glug was very kind for all living things, so that the reason that is the brother also treated him in a bad way. Even they treated their younger brother with badly, and he was doing all the housework, like as cooking, mending. He do all the housework. Younger Gluck and these brothers just enjoy themselves. It means younger brother whose name was Gluck, he was doing all the housework, and other two brothers, that's Scabbard and Hans, who was enjoying themselves. One evening, the two brothers had gone out as usual. They had warned Gluck to let nobody in and give nothing out. Gluck was to get their dinner ready for them. See, one day what happened on evening, that two brothers go outside from the home and they warn Gluck, do not take anyone, do not enter anyone at our home, and do not give anything to anyone. Gluck had to get ready dinner for them. So he was in that preparation when they was left the home. It was raining very hard outside and the weather was very cold. Just then there was a double knock on the door. Gluck went to the window and put his head out to see who it was, and he saw the most extraordinary looking gentleman standing at the door. See, in this paragraph we come to know that the raining was very hard outside and the weather was very cold. At that time Gluck heard a double knock on the door. Then Gluck put his head outside from the window, the upper window at the door, and he see that who was not knocking at the door. He saw an extraordinary man who was standing at the door and knocking the door. See the next passage. The strange visitor was very short, with a large nose, red cheeks, curly mustache and merry twinkling eyes. He wore a conical cap as high as himself and a clock four times as long. I'm wet. Let me in, said the stranger. Now here, when the Glug saw that the visitor he was a short with a large nose, red cheeks, curl mustache and twinkling eyes. He was wearing a conical cap. It was a very high and he was became wet because it was raining, and he was requesting to Glug let him inside in the home. That he was requesting to Glug, I am wet, let me in. The stranger, the gentleman who is knocking on the door, requesting to Glug, let him in the house. See, I beg pardon, sir, said Glug. I am very sorry, but I really can't. My brothers would beat me to death if I did any such thing. See, but Glug said that to him, he couldn't do that because his brothers already given him a warning. If anybody comes in, they would beat him. So Glug was thinking that what to do. Glug was avoid to take him in the house. See, but looking at the situation, but Glug saw hard it was raining and how cold it was and how wet the gentleman looked. So he opened the door and let the stranger in. Glug thought he would let the stranger get warm inside for some time and ask him to leave before his brothers come home. Now here, but looking at the situation, weather which was cold and it was raining, he was the gentleman full wet. So he felt pity on that stranger visitor. Then he opened the door and took him inside the house. He thought that before his brothers returned back, he allowed to stranger visitor to warm himself, became dry, and then let him leave the home. See the next. The stranger, however, had no plans of leaving. In fact, he told Glug that he had nothing to eat for 2 days and was very hungry. It melted Glug's heart to hear this. So he decided to give the stranger a part of his own dinner. Now what happened? Glug allowed the stranger inside. Now the stranger sitting calmly and relaxed. He had no plan of the living. That then the stranger told to the Glug that he had not eaten anything from 2 days. So he was very hungry. As we know that the Glug was very kind person, he melted by hearing what the stranger told him, and then Glug decided to give his own dinner to the stranger, to the gentleman. Before the stranger had eaten, however, the weak brothers returned. They were shocked to see the little gentleman sitting in the house. Now what happened? Before the stranger eaten his dinner, two unkind brothers returned back to home. Squirt and Hans returned back home. When they saw the little gentleman, they were shocked and very angry to see the little gentleman who was sitting in the house. At once the brothers began to shout at Glug. Squirt threw a rolling pin at Glug. At that instant the stranger put his conical cap and the rolling pin went spinning to a corner of the room. The brothers was very angry when they saw the stranger in the house. They started shouting at the Glug. One of the brother threw a rolling pin at the glug. When the stranger saw if he also put a conical cap with the direction of the rolling pin, and rolling pin went to the corner of the room and it fell down. See the next passage. The brothers turn to the visitor and order him to get out of the house. The little man asked them humbly to let him stay as it was so cold and wet outside, but the evil brothers wouldn't listen. They rush at the old man to throw him out of the house. To their surprise, they found that they couldn't touch him. Instead, they were themselves swept into the corner with the rolling pin. Now, what happened here? That the brothers so angry, now they wanted to throw the stranger, that the little man, from their house, and they order him to leave the house. The little man requesting them to stay because it was so cold and wet at the outside of the house. It was raining outside, please allow him to stay in the house. But the evil brothers did not listen. They wanted to throw him out of the house. When even they touch him, they could not do it, and they would swept to the corner like a rolling pin. Then the old gentleman gathered his cloak and cap, said, "At 12 o'clock tonight I will call again. But since you have treated me so badly, it will be the last visit I pay you." Then he went away like a whirlwind. See, the old gentleman was very upset that he gathered his cloak and cap, and he told to evil brothers that 12 o'clock tonight I call you again. If you treated again badly, it will be my last visit. And just he was disappeared like a whirlwind. Whirlwind means what? A column of air moving rapidly around, round and round. The night a big storm woke the brothers. It shook the house and blew away the roof. Once again the weak brother saw the strange visitor. He was sitting on a cloud bobbling up and down. Now the stranger disappeared like a whirlwind. Same there was a big storm. It was destroy everything. It has shaken the house, blew away the roof also. And the weak brothers again saw the stranger who was sitting on the cloud and bobbling up. Now bobbling means what? Moving quickly here and there, upward and downwards. That night a big storm woke the brothers. That house blew away the roof also, and the strangers once again meet the evil brothers. See the next passage. "You may go to your brother's room. I have not damaged it," he told Hans and Kurt. "Remember, this is my last visit. You will find my card on the table." With those words, he disappeared. Now what happened here? The stranger damaged everything due to storm. Told the both of them, that the Hans and Kurt, that his brother's room means, "I will not damage or destroy the glug room. You can stay there. You can stay over. And this was the last visit of mine. I kept a card for you on the table." And suddenly he disappeared. In the morning, the brothers saw from the window that the storm had swept away whole trees, crops, from the treasure valley. Everywhere they saw only red sand and grey mud. The valley was a picture of ruin. And the brothers then crept into the kitchen on the kitchen table there was a small white card. Now in the morning when the brother will get up, that time they saw out of the window all over destroyed by the storm. And when they enter into the kitchen, as the strangers told them, the small little card they found on the table, and there is words which is written for the two brothers only. Let's we see the next part of this story earlier. Thank you.